Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you antenna impedance matching. Before I start with my explanation, let me show you how many things that I'm going to cover in this video. See, first of all, I'll be discussing about basics of antenna impedance matching. After that, I'll explain you three different methods of antenna impedance matching. First method is stub matching. Second method is impedance matching using balloon. And in third method, I'll explain you how one can have impedance matching using folded dipole. So let us begin this video with first agenda, that is basics of antenna impedance matching. To provide supply to the antenna, we use transmission line. And with transmission line, we have characteristic impedance Z0, and that characteristic impedance should get matched with impedance of antenna. Let me explain you how. See, here we have transmission line. This transmission line that we are connecting it with load, here load is antenna. Let us assume antenna's load impedance is ZL. And here characteristic impedance of transmission line, that is Z0. If you don't have proper impedance matching, then there will be reflection of signal. For example, if I say here incident signal is having voltage VI, then because of impedance mismatch in between transmission line and load, there can be reflection of signal that is having voltage VR. And this amount of reflection that one can calculate as per reflection coefficient, rho is equals to VR, that is reflected voltage, divided by VI, that is incident voltage. And if you want to understand this relation in terms of impedance, then that is ZL minus Z0 divided by ZL plus Z0. So here reflection coefficient, that is there based on difference in between ZL and Z0. So if you have different values of characteristic impedance and load impedance, then there will be reflection of signal. And as if you have reflection of signal, then power cannot be delivered to the load. And because of which antenna will radiate low power over here. So to have maximum radiation by this antenna, there has to have impedance matching in between transmission line and load. So what will happen as if you have transmission line that is having different impedance compared to the impedance of antenna. In that situation, we have few methods. Like one can go for stub matching, or one can go for balloon matching, or one can use folded dipole. In this video, I'll explain you these three methods. And one should know, if you have proper impedance matching, then one can achieve these objectives where we can remove mismatch loss. We can also minimize reflection of signal from the load. Here load is antenna, as well as we can maximize the power delivered to the antenna. So impedance matching, that is very much essential task that one should do as and when we use antenna as a transmitter or receiver. Now, I'll explain you first impedance matching method, that is stub matching. In stub matching, we simply use wire to provide impedance matching of transmission line with antenna. If you observe, here we have transmission line that is having characteristic impedance Z0 and load impedance ZL. This load impedance is the impedance of antenna. If you don't have proper impedance matching of Z0 and ZL, then you can use single wire where you need to identify length of the wire and position of the wire. With the identification of L and L dash, one can provide impedance matching of this transmission line with antenna. If you want to understand how exactly we can identify this L and L dash, then you just need to go through my videos in video lecture series of microwave engineering, in which I have derived these equations, as well as I have solved many questions as well. Even I have solved some problems using Smith chart, in which I have explained how to identify L and L dash. See, there is one another stub matching method in which we will be using two wires where we need to identify L1 and L2. Those are length of these two wires, and we need to identify L dash, that is position of second stub with respect to antenna. And here spacing between L1 and L2 is 3/8 lambda. So using double stub also, I have solved few problems in my video lecture series of microwave engineering. If you want to understand this stub matching in more detail, then just go through those videos. Here, I'm just directly telling you, like in stub matching, we will be using wire for impedance matching of transmission line with antenna. Now I'll explain you second method of impedance matching of antenna, in which we will be using balloon. Full form of balloon is balanced to unbalanced line. This balloon is used to provide impedance matching of transmission line with antenna. Let me explain you that by some examples. Like if you observe, here we have balloon transformer, where with this balloon transformer, we have ratio of 1:4, means here we have input that is given from this transmission line, that is coaxial cable. If I say impedance of this coaxial cable is 50 ohm, then here at output of this balloon transformer, impedance will be 50 into 4, means it will be 200. So here you can connect antenna which is having impedance of 200 ohm. So balloon transformer that can be used to provide impedance matching of transmission line with antenna. Here one more structure of balloon that is shown, where here we have balloon that is made up of metal, right? So here we have metal sheet, and this metal sheet that is connected with outer conductor. Length of the sleeve is lambda by 2, and with the adjustment of this spacing D, we can provide impedance matching of antenna with this transmission line. So balloons are used with many circuits, and this balloon, this type of balloon, that is widely used in TV antennas. Now I'll explain you third method of impedance matching, that is folded dipole antenna. In folded dipole antenna, with the use of number of elements, we can identify impedance matching of transmission line with antenna. Let me explain you how. See, here we have transmission line. Let us assume transmission line that is having impedance Z0. Right now consider transmission line is having impedance that is 75 ohm. So in this situation, you can have single dipole over here. If you have single dipole, then that single dipole that will be having impedance, if I say that is ZL, that will be 73 ohm in case of length of dipole is lambda by 2. If I say I have transmission line that is having impedance Z0 that is equals to 300 ohm. So in that situation, what should be my load impedance? So load impedance depends on number of elements. If you have folded dipole with two elements over here, then your load impedance will be 2 square into 73 ohm. So that will be somewhere around 300 ohm, right? And if you have transmission line that is having impedance of 600 ohm, in that case, you can have three elements. If you have three elements, then load impedance will be 3 square into 73. So you will be observing this will be somewhere around 650 ohm, right? So based on transmission line impedance, one can select number of elements over here, and number of elements will define load impedance of this antenna. Here with folded dipole, if you have n number of elements, then impedance is n square into 73. How this equation is coming? That I have already derived in my earlier videos of this antennas and wave propagation lecture series, in which I have derived this equation as well. So in total, in general, we are using three methods, but very popular method is balloon, where in majority of cases, we will be using balloon transformer. And with the use of balloon transformer, you can identify output impedance. Here, balloon transformer is having ratio of 1:4. Based on that, we have selected output impedance of 200 ohm. But based on requirement, one can fabricate balloon transformer as well. I hope you have enjoyed this session. Still, if anything that you'd like to share, just note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.